kindly pump oil well for quantum for our capacity to Liberia, which is the West African country where salt plantations are there. I have designed this tiny palm oil mill for small plantation owners so that they can have their own palm oil mill and sell out crude palm oil. So to extract crude palm oil, here is the complete palm oil mill. The first equipment is sterilizer. So we have provided here 3 sets of sterilizers with 4 vessels in each group. So you can see here there are 4 vessels in which palm bunches will be put and steam will be given to it. Here is the steam pipe, well continuous, and from the bottom of this pan the steam will be introduced, and then this is lined in unloading condition, but it will be erected vertical, and then palm bunches will be filled up into it, and there will be lid over it. So we will see the demonstration also, because by hand it cannot be lifted, so there must be some device. So we have put the wire rope device. You can see how it is lifted. This way it will be lifted. It will be in a vertical position. Now in this position, palm bunches of tendra or dura, newly harvested, ripe, it will be filled up with it. And then it will be covered. All the vessels will be covered. So there are 4 vessels here in this group, controlled by a person here. After giving the steam for 1 hour or 45 minutes, as per the circumstances, because we cannot predict how much time it will take to sterilize everything. After sterilization, it will be unloaded, and unloading will be difficult because it will be hot, and it should not fall abruptly. So we have provided here latex arrangement. One stop will be there as per our desire. We can stop in a particular position if we want, and it will prevent falling abruptly. So now we will see how it is descended. Now this palm bunches, newly sterilized, will fold into this tray, or it can be drawn from inside if it is not falling automatically. Then all this tray, lifted by 2 persons by handle, will go to a next machine, which is called palm should stripper. Before we go there, we may complete here that there are three such sets. Look here. All this, here also four vessels, and then in there also four vessels. So totally 12 vessels we are providing. One ton of palm bunches will be sterilized here. Now we can further understand here that entire structure is holding. You can see here nut and bolt, here nut and bolt, everywhere, here also. So everything can be dismantled and then dispatched into a container. Otherwise this only one machine will go into one container if we do not dismantle. So we have to dismantle it completely. So we have provided everything folding, but on the side, if you feel that we can weld here everything, it is permanent, then you can weld it if you think so. Otherwise, we have prepared with a folding arrangement with nuts and bolts. And here foundation bolt arrangement also has been made. If you want to make a foundation to this one, there is a provision here. Here also it is there. Here also it is a foundation bolt hole is there. So I think I have covered perfectly about sterilizing of palm bunches. Now we can go to the next machine, which is palm fruit stripper. Wheel is power independent. No electricity is required. No electric motor will be there. Everything runs by steam engine, and steam is generated in a boiler by burning palm waste. So biomass boiler will be provided. That also will be shown next day after finishing this video. It is at the another factory. Here is a palm fruit stripper, which function of which is to separate out palm fruits from the sterilized bunches. So bunches will be put into this display, will be unloaded into this one, and bunches will be put into the stripper. In stripper there are pegs revolving, and it will jump the bunches, jump and fall. We will see now. We will start the steam engine by air compressor, but actually steam engine will be here. Bunches are, the pegs are revolving, so it will jump the bunches and fall it, jump and fall. So fruits will be separated and will fall down inside this, and here there is a bottom conveyor which will convey and will take away. It will discharge of the here, and it will be taken out. It will directly fall into this hopper, because we have to put an excavation pit here and fit it here inside, below the ground little bit, so that fruit coming from this must fall into this one.
We have connected air compressor, compressed air, it is running by compressed air, but it will run by steam. So, air will steam inlet.
will take out here. The urethra stain, the blood stain will come out from here and pipeline will take away the urethra stain. Now we can see. Now the end of the plant will touch, then it will progress. The empty bunches from beginning to end here and empty by this is here, it will be completely empty if it is really matured and sterilized. Then it will come out from here, automatically it will come out. So I have already explained that palm fruits separated from palm bunches will come out from this one, this discharge tube, and it will fall into this one. There will be excavation pit here and this will go a little bit underground. And it will raise the fruit by this conveyor to the digester kettle by means of an electric motor. Electric motor will be run by a generator, which I will explain you separately. So this, here is a digester kettle. And steam will be provided through here. For heating it and also for mixing, steam has been provided here through this one between the two bottoms. Here is a bottom, here is also bottom, and there is an annular space in between. There will be steam to heat up the palm fruits, and also some steam will be mixed up from here. There will be valve here, and the valve has not been provided, but should be valve should be there. So lot of steam will be required to heat up and to cook the palm fruit. Here is the explorer which we will show actually. This is the discharge of the digester kettle and it will fall directly into the explorer hopper. Now we will see here the construction. So we can see here that there are the worms screws going up to the end. We will see separately also the construction of it. And here there will be a discharge cone. The cone can be adjusted little away or nearer or away from this place, and their annular space will increase or decrease. So it will be remaining in such a way that palm kernels, palm kernels will come out whole without breaking. Palm nuts should come out without breaking with the fibers. So what will come out here is a mixture of nut and fiber, and all the oils extracted will fall down here. There will be a tank here, it is not here, but tank will be put into this here, and all oil will come out here, and from that tank that we will take away the oil, crude palm oil, by the pump which we call mud pump, because it is very thick, just like a mud. So by mud pump it will be lifted into the clarifier tank, which also we will show. Now we will see the by running actually by a steam engine. Here is a double cylinder steam engine of 40 horsepower. In fact,
total load will not be, will never increase more than 20 HP, but we have provided bigger engine, 40 HP, so that you can utilize extra power for some another purpose or for running any machine also. So we will see actually running the steam engine by compressed air. Steam, this person holding the valve where the steam will be given.
Direction of rotation is important. Adjust this cone by tightening or loosening by four studs. In such a way that the whole nut should come out without cracking. If any other state you can see here, it can be increased or decreased by means of the stud. And then it can be shifted up the position that it can. Yeah, now this is lubricating pump, and you can have one or two strokes every 5 minutes or 10 minutes. And this is a lubricating oil tank. Small one. I will steam inlet and SO. You know, this is tunnel view from this one to conveyor to digest the kettle and then palm expeller, palm oil expeller. Air compressor. This is running by air compressor, but we have to detect, use the steam here. We have to use the steam here, steam line. This will be removed. This will be removed. This is for, just for air compressor. This is a nut fiber separator. We have seen that in the palm expeller, from the side, mixture of palm nuts and fibers will come out. And it should be separated. Fibers should be separated from the nuts. Then nut can go to another oil expeller. So that will be put into this hopper. And this is an inclined revolving Jali means this will be revolved by one horsepower electric motor which we have seen here and gearbox, and this will be revolving. So fibers will come out from this hole. Holes are specifically designed for the fibers. It will come out and fall down here, and nuts will come out here. But will be collected here, and some hopper, yeah, this will be there. Still ahead. Okay. So then nut will come here. So this is simple thing.
Now question is of electricity, that this motor is an electric motor of 1 HP. So electricity will be generated specially for this motor of nut fiber, one motor of conveyor, and two more equipment are here to install. This is boiler feed pump. Here is inlet, here is outlet. So this will supply the water to the boiler with a big pressure, against the pressure inside the boiler. So pressure of this water pump should be bigger than steam pressure inside the boiler. So this is also run by electric motor. How many HP? This is 3 HP electric motor, and here also there is a mud pump for lifting the crude palm oil from a tank below the expeller, and it will go to clarifier tank, big tank, which we'll show later on. So there are 4 electric motors are involved. One is here, then 3 HP motor for boiler feed pump, and for conveyor also 1.5 HP motor is there, and for nut fiber separator, which we have already seen. So all the four motors, we have provided a generator, 12.5 kVA generator run by steam engine. This is the 12.5 kVA generator. From this generator you can give the power to all the four motors whenever it is required. We will see this also by running the This is actually run by compressed air at the moment. But here, steam line will be connected. So, all this equipment can be arranged, or layout should be such that minimum pipelines are there from the boiler. Now, steam generator means boiler. Also, we have to, in the part of this project, we will see boiler later on to the separate entity also. So we will have a separate video for the boiler, how it is generated steam, how it generates steam from the biomass. What is biomass? That's the waste of the palm waste and fibers will be utilized as fuel of the boiler. So boiler will be biomass fire water to boiler, which will generate 1250 kilogram of steam, which we will see later on. Here is the oil clarifier tank, which is the last equipment of the palm oil mill. So whatever oil is collected from oil expeller is transferred through the oil pump, that is mud pump, into this tank. This tank has a lot of capacity, which will be filled up to 40% only, and then 60% water will be added. So oil quantity multiplied by 1.5 times, water is to be added into it, and it is filled up to the upper level or whatever it may be, and then it is allowed to stay as it is without any disturbance to the oil and water. Now during the few hours water which is heavier than oil will go down at the bottom, and oil which is lighter than water will come up. So all the oil will come up, all the water will go down. Now here we are going to put the coupling at 1 feet here, again here, third will be here, fourth will be here, like that at every 1 feet height, 300 mm height. And then we will fit the cocks. Then by some sticks inserting vertically from the above, we can judge by which level there is a water and which level there is a oil. So separating mark can be seen that here is the separating level. So above the separating level there is a oil, which is good, and we have to decant it from the cock. So suppose up to this level is a separation mark, so above this level is a oil and below this level is a water. So if there is a cock on the above, then we will decant all the oil from that cock. That is a good oil. And the water which is below, it is to be drained and thrown away. So by some adjustment we can carry out this separation work and taking out the good oil and little bit mixed layer also will be there, which is also again to be used for separation. And there is a, you can see the at the bottom there is a coupling, so we can drain the entire tank from there. We will have a cock there, valve there. So this is the little function of this oil clarifier tank which we see here. So this completes our process of palm oil mill. But one more equipment most responsible for this oil mill process is the steam generator, that is boiler. Now we will see boiler and we will understand what it is. So we go to the boiler. Here is the water tube boiler. We are looking from the front. This is biomass boiler. So we have to burn any biomass at the bottom through this opening. This is water tube boiler. So water is inside the tube and it is evaporated into steam. So on all the sides there is a vertical pipelines which contains water. And inside we can see bent tubes, skeleton of bent tubes. It is super heater tubes. So steam generated into this boiler is further heated so that no any water particle or moisture remains in the steam, because steam engine requires purely dry steam. This boiler has a capacity of 1250 kilogram of steam per hour. we have to fit various fittings. Suppose there will be water level gauge set here and here, here and here. Water level gauge set. These are the this is the steam pipe going out to the steam engines for utilizing the steam. And this is drain cocks. This is for filling the water inside the boiler with the water feed pump will be connected here. So this boiler will provide steam to all the three steam engines for oil expeller, palm oil expeller, to the palm fruit stripper, and one generator driven by 20 HP steam engine. And palm oil expeller is driven by 40 HP steam engine, and palm fruit stripper is driven by 10 HP steam engine. Totally 70 HP steam engines will be there. This boiler is capable to supply steam to all the three steam engine plus whatever process steam required into digester kettle. Now this boiler is not complete now because outer cover is to be fitted. We have fitted only angles. You can see the angles frame. On this frame will be fitted this grill, and over this grill there will be insulation, and above the insulation there will be galvanized sheet covering. From this we will have a video once again after completion of this things. So we will have a little, but inside view also we should know. So this video I am taking just to show inside construction of the boiler. At the bottom you can see the pipes which will be act as a fire grate. We can see very vividly from here. This tubes at the bottom full of water will be heated with the fuel fired on it. Now this is economizer. Inside this all pipelines which we see is a economizer. Economizer simply heats the water by means of a flue gases. So various header pipes and tubes emerging from the header pipes can be seen. And in the center there is a big header pipe, or steam storage will be inside that big pipe, which can be seen. On the top there will be water level safety valve and pressure gauge, and some of the extra fittings also will be there if required, and two hooks for lifting the boiler bracket. So now we understand what is boiler. Inside this pipes can be seen through, and it does not contain any water, but flue gases pass through it and it will go through the chimney, which will be on the top of the economizer. On the top of this will be a chimney erected over it. So, thank you for your patience.